So in the previous tutorial, we used command prompt to write our very first Python program. The only problem with that approach was that we could not save the code we wrote for later use. The solution to this problem is to write the code onto a file and save that into our operating system. That's exactly what we will be learning today. What's up internet, I am Manish from RebellionWriter.com and welcome to another tutorial of an awesome series of Python programming. In today's tutorial, we will learn how to create scripts in Python programming version 3. To do that, we will be using IDLE editor of Python language. So without wasting time, let's get started. But before that, please consider giving this video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Now, let's start. In order to create a Python script, we have to create a file with a compatible file extension. Most widely used file extension for Python scripts is .py, and some less used ones are .pyw and .py3. .py3 is a new extension introduced with the version 3 of Python programming language, famously known as Python 3. It is rarely used file extension in Python programming. .pyw is the Python file extension for Windows, and the scripts with this extension are executed with pythonw.exe, whereas all other Python scripts will be executed with python.exe. Another Python supported file extension is .pyc. As we learned that Python is an interpreted programming language. Therefore, whenever we interpret Python scripts using Python's interpreter, it automatically generates a file with .pyc extension corresponding to the scripts. You must be wondering, what does a .pyc file consist? Similar to programming language like Java, Python's interpreter compiles the source code of your scripts into a special machine code called bytecode. Bytecode is then executed by Python's virtual machine. I suppose there are in total 19 or maybe more Python supported file extensions. In order to save your time, I will do a brief Facebook note explaining all those extensions on my Facebook page. You can find the link in the description. That being said, let's move ahead. In order to keep everything organized, let's first create a directory where we will save all our Python scripts. I'm going to create this directory in my document folder, which is pretty much empty, as you can see here. You can create a folder anywhere you want in your operating system and name it whatever you want. I will name this folder Python Tutorials. Great. Next, we have to create a Python script. Physically, a script is a file which contains a set of instructions and has a unique name as well as a dedicated file extension which is accepted by the language. In Python programming language, that dedicated extension is .py. So let's start with creating a text file and then we will change its name and extension. Now go to the new items and choose text document. This will create a new text file. Now we have to rename it. You can name your Python script whatever you want, but make sure its extension must always be .py. I will name my script as tut3.py. You might get this warning. Simply hit yes and move ahead. Now you will see that the icon of your file has been changed. That indicates that you have successfully created an empty Python script. Now we will learn how to edit a Python script using IDLE GUI. In order to write some code onto this script, we need to open it with some sort of IDE or editor. Luckily, Python installation comes with a free IDE known as IDLE. IDLE stands for Integrated Development and Learning Environment. It is a graphic user interface which lets you write, edit, and execute a Python program. You can launch it either directly from your start menu or from the right-click menu of the script file. Let me demonstrate. Right-click on the script which we just created and choose Edit with IDLE. You must have this option in your right-click menu. If you don't, then please check the installation video of Python 3. Anyways, here we have our IDLE editor open for us. Now let's write a very simple code onto our script. Let's do one thing. Let's write a code that will show you the latest version of Python installed on your system. How about that? I think it's a great idea. Let's do it. Wait, I think this default font is pretty small and almost unreadable. Let's fix it and then we will write the rest of our code. Go to Options, choose Configure IDLE. Font face is set to Courier New. I'm good with this font, but I'm not happy with the font size. So by default, it is set on 10. Let's increase it to say 18. Good. Also, let's make it bold too. Now, let's also change the theme. Go to Highlight tab and change the theme from IDLE Classic to IDLE Dark. Great. Now, hit Apply and OK. Now I guess this will be comfortable for our eyes. Now let's write the remaining code. In order to print the latest version of Python, we need to use the version method from sysmodule. And to do that, we first need to import the sed module into our program. That is what we did in the first line. In the second line, we just printed a formatted character string. In the third line, we called the version method of sysmodule. That completes our code. Now, we have a complete Python script in our hands. Next, we have to learn how to execute this script. Let's do that. Executing the code using IDLE is as simple as slicing butter. To execute the code in IDLE, first you need to save the changes you have made in the script. Simply press Ctrl plus S and you are done. Next, go to Run. Choose Run Module or you can simply press F5 function key. This will launch your Python shell where you can see the output of your program. As you can see here, the latest version of Python installed is 3.7.1. IDLE is a very minimalistic IDE with very basic features. For example, it doesn't come with a debugging tool. It justifies its name, Integrated Development Learning Environment, as it's good for learning purposes but not suitable for intense coding. Anyways, in the next video, we will be learning how to execute Python scripts using command prompt. So, stay tuned. Meanwhile, I want you to comment and let me know if you have ever used the debug feature of an IDE for your code. Remember, I'm waiting for your comments and very eager to read them. Moreover, do make sure to give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends on your social media. Most importantly, subscribe to the YouTube channel if you haven't already. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionWriter.com.